So, Spice Marine!
Father Emperor!
Alright. So I'm kind of convinced that the bolter on his hip grows. Like, when he picks it up. When he grabs it, it, like, seems bigger in his hand than it is on his hip.
Everything's in slow motion!
So, Ryan and Bridget can't record this week. There's this thing in Vegas between, like, some Filipino senator wanting to beat the crap out of some American boxer or something.
Yeah. I couldn't get tickets for it.
Yeah.
That's why I'm here.
But, yeah, Ryan and Bridget can't be here this week, so we're just going to play video games instead. And why are we playing this, by the way?
I don't know.
Because it's Space Marines!
For the Emperor?
I've played exactly enough of this game to determine it's a bad game.
Well, I beat the whole thing, and I had fun, but yeah, it's not a very great game. It's not very good for replaying.
I'm
going to
play it easy, because I'm bad at this kind of game.
Yeah, you
man.
Are. Oh, look at that.
I had high hopes for the game, because like the graphics were like...
Grimdark! Guys,
Grimdark feature.
There is a loot wall.
Grimdark.
Loot
wall. What is it good for?
Absolutely nothing. Sing it again, yeah.
So, yeah, I had high hopes for this game because it looked pretty fun.
It looked good.
It looked good.
All the necessary things to make it good.
Enhance.
Designation forward.
So I'm the only one here that's actually beaten it, and I've beaten it on Naz's computer. That's why it asked if you wanted to reload from previous checkpoint. Because I beat the whole game on your computer one time.
Yeah, when I wasn't anywhere.
I think I've played it the second most. I've played a few hours, several hours of the game. It's like right when it first came out, I played quite a bit of it.
I tried the multiplayer for like a little bit.
Yeah, so did I.
It was bad.
It's, like I said, not very much.
Yes,
Terminitas!
This would have been so much easier if we could just nuke the planet.
Estimated reduction.
But the game would be over by then. Liberation Fleet?
5 to 37 days.
That's the perils of the warp, Nile.
Ugh.
The perils of the warp.
Yeah, this is what happens.
You may not show up.
You know what I'm hearing a whole lot of behind me? Heresy.
What?
Adeptus
Astartes
Ultra!
It's all your spots. That's all I can say to myself.
Okay, so I get...
Deploying as blue guys. Space Marines.
Stereotypical blue Space Marines.
So, like, I get that they choose the Ultramarines for the game that is called Space Marine, but god, they're the worst chapter!
It's their, like, super ideal. I mean, it's like their, like...
Sega,
the premier chapter of Space Marines, like everyone knows Space Marines.
So okay,
yeah, at least in the multiplayer you can choose different chapters.
So what's the multiplayer like? Is Space Marine versus Space Marine?
It's Space Marine versus Chaos Space Marine.
It's awkward, and you know, it comes naturally to them. They're always like,
down with the false emperor.
It's bad.
Is it just big arena battles?
Yeah,
or what?
It's kind of like deathmatch. I don't remember all of the
Fury of Descent.
Secure the Titans. Because Titans,
I don't remember the Titans.
You don't remember the Titans?
Sorry, it was a joke that fell flat.
Okay.
So, what's with these, like, bolts in his forehead?
That's where they injected his, Imperial loyalty.
Oh, okay.
So, by the way, your Space Marine doesn't care about helmets.
See, okay, I wouldn't want to be a commander in the Imperial military because it's like, hey, you're in charge, give me your goddamn helmet. You can't have that.
Yeah, you don't get helmet.
You're not allowed to have a helmet. You're
not allowed to have one.
Well, you're showing to your lowers that you're invulnerable.
That guy that's like your assistant dude or whatever, veteran sergeant or whatever that guy is, he has like this big acid burn on the side of his face. You know what to protect him from that?
A helmet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jetpack!
We're gonna fade away and put this jetpack on him and fade back because we don't want to show you that he's physically incapable of reaching behind him.
Yeah.
I don't think he's physically capable of touching his face.
Dude, he's not physically capable of looking left or right.
Well, he's looking left now.
Yeah, he had to turn to do it.
He's turning the whole body. that guy reminds me of that guy from Game of Thrones who used to be like the Night Watch, or whatever. The Night Watch Commander?
Oh.
Yeah.
Lord Commander of the Night Watch? Yeah.
Roar for the
ball! Can we use the jetpacks that direction so we can go down faster?
That's how it's done.
Don't you know like, about if you, physics, Nile?
If you were falling at normal speed, you'd be getting hit by debris and stuff.
Or laser fire. Look at that big orc ship. We got a big orc ship. We're going to there, aren't we?
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Kajoo.
More Daka! More Daka!
Jeez.
So, like, I...
All those things blowing
up. We got an air-to-surface space marine missile.
Yeah, that's right there.
All right.
That's the best part of the game. Right.
Woo!
There.
Boom, got done. Me a pistol and a... What would probably be a longsword to most people, or a machete, is like...
A knife?
It's like a pocket knife to a space marine.
I don't know, that's still pretty long for a knife, even on a space marine. But that's like a claymore on the hands of a normal man. A
mortal man.
Yeah, a mere mortal.
So, if you haven't played this game, there's a lot of melee combat. You have a gun, but it's just kind of...
Fuck guns. I'm a space marine!
Yeah, just space marines!
These are the guys that'll, like, get into close combat with a tank. You stick in a tank, but they're like, nope, I'm going to hit it with a sword.
Just because.
I mean, why else are going to have a sword? You just...
Boom! Headshot!
So you have recharging shields and a health bar.
Yep.
So if you get through that...
Kind of like the first Halo game.
Yeah. If you get through that whole thing, you kind of suck. So Niall, if you die, you suck.
Yeah, well, I told you, I'm like, okay, third-person, like, hack-and-slash and shooter games, I've never been very good at. I really didn't care for... What's that shitty bromance game where it's like totally...
Oh,
like
Army of Two!
No, that one. Not the one I've seen. The one that's like the two guys who clearly love each other, and I don't know why they can't admit it. Gears of War.
Gears of War.
Yeah, that's the one. They're clearly in love with each other. I don't know why they don't see it.
I don't remember much of that game. I try to...
Oh, man, the capture's lagging, man. Look at that.
Space Marine!
Well, so...
You're not missing much, trust me.
So, orcs, they're like... extra heretical, right? I mean, they're aliens.
They're an affront to the Emperor.
And they reproduce asexually, which has to be heretical.
That's an abomination of some kind.
Yeah, that has to be.
They're like spores or something.
And Jake, is there a way to, like, get health back, or...?
You have to kill dudes.
What? Can I kill them with my pistol? Because I like shooting.
You have to execute them. See, it says provide a stun and then B to execute to gain health.
So here's where we tell everyone. Despite what it looks like on the screen, we're playing this on a computer, and I'm using an Xbox controller. And I don't play Xbox. I don't really know the buttons. I kind of wish there was a way for it to come up and tell me what the buttons were on the PlayStation. That would be more natural to me.
Yeah, because Niall plays PlayStation.
Yeah,
in case you guys haven't figured that out.
I own a 360.
Yeah.
But I hardly play them. My gamer score is like 2,000? 5,000?
Guess what mine is?
100? Yeah, oh, no, it's like... zero. Your account got hacked, remember?
Oh, yeah.
You had to make a new account.
Someone wanted my name.
Yeah.
They hacked it, changed my name, and then took that name, because when I went to change it back, it was like, That name's already taken.
That's what you get for making your password, jackass.
I did not make my password.
I don't believe it. I bet you did.
That's a big
Marine.
Space Marine!
Oh, see that shiny part on the front of that? I bet that's a weak spot.
That's a big one.
Now, if it were flashing red, I would agree with you.
So, I'm going to spoil it a little bit. That dude later on, you have to kill in a boss fight, and he is hard. Compared to the last boss.
Is he as hard as I am right now?
He's hard compared to the last boss.
Because, man, these killing orcs.
Well, yeah.
So, the Emperor is like and all the war bullshit. Boss or something?
Yeah, he's the war boss. He's leading this entire WOG!
How many A's is that exactly?
Like 12, and then there's a hyphen, and. Yeah. I think there's like 4.
I think minimum A's in WOG is like 6, I think.
Yeah.
I think it's...
Otherwise, it's not legit.
No, it's not. It's just some dude saying WOG, and you're like, what does that even mean? Even orcs are like, that's not even a word. What do you...
Oh, Niall's dying. Oh, he needs to blow the crap out of everything.
Execute the shit out of somebody.
Yeah, do it to regain health or something. Now, press it. B. Or not.
Okay, see, like I said, I don't play PlayStation or Xbox, so I don't know the controls.
Okay.
Press B now.
A is X and B is circle.
Yeah. If you told me X or circle is B, yeah. There we go.
I remember because of the same as the Super Nintendo.
See, I mean, I played Super Nintendo when I was younger. That was a long time.
Well, then, but it's A B X A B Y and X, and it's like.
I know.
I don't know. It, like I said, it doesn't lend itself well. I mean, it helps when you later get the sniper rifle and the plasma gun and whatnot.
So, okay. So something we were going to talk about with Ryan and Bridget that we're now not able to, but was this last weekend Avengers came out. Right?
I want to say something really. This is one dumb fucking orc that just keeps firing when you turn his into the ship.
I mean, orcs are dumb, but
dumb, but that one's particularly dumb.
Yeah, so let's talk about something.
He's like the smoker, like the gunner on the smokers in Waterworld. Waterworld. He's got like the smoke on his goggles that he can't see.
No, I don't think so.
Kevin Costner.
Kevin Costner's the main character.
Oh yeah, from Waterworld.
Yeah.
You know Jack Black was in that movie?
Yeah, he was the pilot.
The pilot. I don't think he was... I think he was uncredited.
No, I think he was.
I don't remember.
I think he was just credited as pilot, though.
I just remember one day watching that, like, years after it came out. I think it was, like, on TV or something. Nolan and I were watching it. We're like, was that Jack Black?
Yes, indeed.
Holy shit, that was Jack Black!
Right? So, anyway, we're talking about
something good. Avengers came out.
Yeah. That was cool.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
That was Miles very convoluted.
James Spader is the best thing in that movie,
mm-hmm.
easily
by far. Like, they got the banter going between
the heroes.
Man,
I hit my head hard, but God, I wish I had a helmet.
Space Marine.
Yeah, you know that's not a
Space Marine.
Well, you know that's not a part in his hair. That's a scar that that it would have avoided if he had a helmet.
Nah, we don't want to do that.
Damn it! Oh, shot me off course.
So, slowly through this game, you get bigger and bigger guns.
Yeah, and you
get bigger guns. With a bolt gun and a knife.
Right. Well, pretty soon you get a chainsword, which is way cooler.
My favorite was the power sword.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
I didn't think I played hard enough to get a power sword.
I really wish you could have gotten a power fist, because that would have been more fun than the hammer. Because the hammer, you don't get any, like, you get the pistol. Whereas with the sword, you get everything else. Right. I like the bolt gun. I like the plasma gun, and you know, it's a lot of fun that way. And I feel like limiting you is.
Does the bolt gun heat up? I mean, the plasma gun.
Yes,
plasma gun gets hot, Nolan. That's what the rule is.
Yeah, gets hot.
We all actually play or have dabbled. I'll say at least in Warhammer, right?
Yeah, played it back in middle school.
We played it quite a lot in our lives, but not for some time.
Yeah, well, I mean, God.
Boom.
I've got multiple, like, 2,000 or 3,000 point armies. But Avengers, though.
Yeah, right. Good stuff.
Oh, yeah, yep. I can sprint. So, I mean, it was fun. They screwed up Hawkeye's character from what he's supposed to be in the comics. And, I mean, I expect some divergence, but this was pretty severe.
Yeah, but it was in a... Oh, I don't want to spoil anything.
I don't feel like they need to follow the comics.
No,
that's where you and I differ.
Well, here's the thing: like, I don't want them to follow the comics exactly, but I'd like for them to at least like get the idea and the basic mentality of the characters the same.
I understand why they changed Hawkeye the way they did. I don't want to say anything because it like really would spoil stuff.
Shoot a boys.
Unless we don't care about that. Do we care about that?
Let's not spoil it.
Well, I mean. Yeah.
I mean, if you haven't seen it by this point, go and watch it.
Yeah, what were you doing this week instead of watching Avengers? Watching the fight?
Yeah, watching the Pacquiao and the most boring fight
ever.
Yeah, so I guess it ended based on points, and people are pissed off.
Yeah, that's a long story if you want to ever actually get into it. I didn't watch it.
It brought money,
so much money into Vegas.
Yeah.
And a lot of stupidly wealthy people. Oh, I mean, yeah. Stupidly wealthy. I mean, there were tickets going for $350,000.
Did you
see
that picture of the airport?
Why don't you bring up that picture of the airport at this point, Nolan? McCarran Airport is the international airport here in Vegas. And Terminal 2, which is where all the private jets land, was like a parking lot.
Yeah, Vegas gets a lot of tourism.
Obviously.
Obviously.
But this was on a whole new level.
No, the hell you say?
Even Las Vegas watching this whole thing go down was like, holy shit.
So basically, we had like news reports in Vegas saying on Saturday night, if you don't have to be on the strip,
don't
go on the strip.
Just don't.
Okay?
Yeah, don't even go near the casino. If you don't have tickets to the show,
one of the parties.
If you don't have a room key at the hotel, any of the hotels, just don't even bother showing up to the strip. Don't even try crossing. Because I did on Friday night, going from work back to school to do some stuff. And it took me probably about an hour to get across the strip.
Yeah, that's what I was hearing from a lot of people. It's like about 3 blocks.
You should have taken the Beltway, man. From work to school that day, you should have taken the Beltway.
Yeah.
You know...
I was going down the street, I was like, wow, this is the fastest ever we've gone down this street. And then I got down there, I was like, oh, that's right, because they're all going away from this area.
Cool. Yeah. But anyway, so for those people that are watching the fights and watching Avengers, A, shame on you.
Shame on you, you're a terrible person. You're a
bad nerd.
Because you didn't let me watch the fight.
Bad nerd. B, I'm not going to say it was a bad movie, it was a good movie. I liked it better than the first Avengers, which apparently I'm in the minority on that one.
No, I liked it more than the first. But it felt more epic.
But here's the thing, though.
It's a grenade. Do your roll.
It's not that I was... it's not that I disliked the first one, it's that I was largely unimpressed by it. And I don't know if it's like, at this point, like, I'm just...
That's heresy, by the way, according to a lot of people. It's sticking with our Space Marine theme, heresy.
Yeah, so, okay.
Yeah, that's the theme this week, is
so,
heresy.
So, it was well done, the dialogue was done well, whatever. I don't think Joss Whedon is the god that nerds think.
No, I think Firefly is good.
And yeah, everything outside of Firefly, I'm not like big fan of Joss Whedon on.
No, and in this
like, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is okay. It's fun.
Is he in that? Is he involved in that?
What's he's producer
of
that?
Yeah.
He's producer in that.
But yeah, so that dude looks like Mike Trout. Look at him.
Oh, he shot that dude's legs off. Oh, in the face!
He's a player for the Angels. If you don't know who Mike Trout is,
and shame on you if you don't know that.
Yeah, if you're in any way a fan of baseball, you know who Mike Trout is. But anyway, so I like the original one well enough. I was kind of unimpressed. And I don't know if it's because I'm at a point where I just sort of I'm just gonna skip this.
Oh, that really is a scar, not a part.
So
it really wasn't that funny a joke.
So I think, Bratz.
One of the things I get tired of in this game, by the way, is that it's just every 2 seconds, like, let's just send an endless wave of green skins. And then you move
on. Or later on, the other enemy that you fight in this game. I'm not going to spoil it.
It's chaos.
It's chaos.
It's always chaos. Every freaking 40K game is chaos.
Oh, really?
It was chaos in Ultramarines. It was chaos. Or in Fire Warrior. It was chaos in Dawn of War. It was chaos. I'm pretty sure it's chaos in Dawn of War 2.
I thought it was chaos.
It's chaos every.
Did I play this game? I don't remember. Did I?
This game?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you beat it.
I didn't remember.
It's always chaos.
It's been a long time since I played this game. What was it? That was like 2013.
No, but anyway.
And December. Even if it's not chaos and it happens to actually be like Tyranids, it's chaos. The chaos of the Tyranids or something.
Yeah, chaos always wins over.
Chaos did it.
Yep.
Yeah, it's always chaos' fault.
But yeah.
But okay, so anyway, and I don't know if it was like by the time Avengers came out, I was at a point where like, the level of action and effects and everything that was in it was just kind of expected. And so I didn't have anything to be impressed by.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's not like we jumped from...
Oh, God.
It's not like we jumped from the Hulk, the Edward Norton Hulk, which at the time looked good, but by comparison now looks like garbage. You know, it's not like we jumped from that to Avengers. We had... You know, years of
or
Iron
even
Man,
the,
Captain America, and Thor,
or even the John Woo Hulk.
Yeah,
which
like,
John Woo what
Hulk?
Ah,
yeah.
The one prior to
I mean, so it's all it's like
one.
We had.
I thought that one was the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah,
the Edward Norton one from like 2007.
That's the one that is canon
that's
with
the current
MCU.
With the Avengers.
Oh, okay.
With the MCU.
Okay.
I couldn't remember which one was first. I try not to remember these kinds of things.
Well, it's because the Hulk's a bad character.
It's boring.
Oh, yeah, so when...
A bad character would be super...
We noticed after the fact that, oh, yeah, that, they sell these... At the theater, they were selling, like, these toppers.
Yeah, you put on the cup, and it you put the special lid on your...
Where else would your lieutenant be but on the front lines? Because any good soldier leads from the front... In this,
I will find this
because they, but they started with a general and then he led from the front of the night and then he had like a colonel.
You know what the problem was? they didn't have
Creed.
Yeah, well, see, Creed would have like a Bane blade hiding behind that corpse there,
And somehow you would never see it until you're already dead. And you're
right,
like, oh,
I mean, that's how Creed operates.
Creed wins, I guess.
Right. But so anyway.
Oh, look at all those dead bodies. And wounded.
Like, could you imagine, like, the space frame walking through, actually, like, steps on some wounded guy's leg while he's on the ground?
And it makes that twig snap sound, ooh, like in cartoons. Snap! And you look down, it's pushing a twig, and it's some dude's
like... It's like, oh, how are you, soldier? Oh, God! Oh, I'm so sorry! Oh!
I'm just such a klutz in these big feet of mine, I...
No, okay, so...
I mean, they did get it... It feels right. It feels like you are this huge, hulking thing. And you are better off, just like in 40K,
like
you are better off.
The ground shakes when you run, so
right.
Come on.
Yeah, I feel like they got that right. It was really cool just watching your character stomp on the ground and the earth shakes. And when you move, you're very slow and purposeful about it. When you need to be.
Alright.
Yeah, like, you feel
also,
bulky.
There's no squat button.
No,
there's no crouch button.
Space Marines don't need cover.
Yeah, covers for
have
pussies.
Have you ever played the miniatures game? My God, they're better than...
That was my first army, dude. I know. Trust me.
Space Marines don't get cover because you either get cover or you get armor, and your armor's better than your cover.
Yeah.
I don't know why you can't stack cover and armor.
Although, the cover is invulnerable. That's the big deal.
Yeah, that's true. For you.
Good. I guess. Got that gun well defended, no mistake. Did they taste good? Like...
Yeah, I dig in this dude's, like, big old Judge Dredd pauldrons, though. It's
yeah,
really cool.
Looks stylish.
Yeah.
So, anyway, back to our Avengers talk. So, for me, though, the real thing, the real reason for me, because I went and saw it twice, the real reason for me to, like, be willing to see it a second time was the fact that James Spader did such a good job voicing Ultron.
Absolutely.
God, it was so well done.
Oh yeah, he was really good in that.
Nice strike, light a stun. Okay.
Chainsword!
Yeah, as I was saying though, like the reason I stopped playing this is I got tired of it's just like, enter an area and then fight an endless tide of orcs for several minutes and then move on to the next area and do the same exact thing. Repetitive. It's like they just add these endless tides. Like, I understand they're orcs and they're big.
Like, my Xbox is going to be worn out by the end of this, man.
And there's like this huge horde because they're orcs. But it's like they added it just to extend the life of the game.
Yeah, and it didn't necessarily need it.
Right. It's just like, oh, our game's too short.
Let's add another horde here, and then put another horde here.
Because I've played games like that before, where they do, like, these... They add, like, these stupid, like...
Order 1886!
Right. Like, stupid fetch quests and random things that just... Their only purpose, it seems to be... serve is to extend the gameplay.
Which is usually bad gameplay.
Yeah, and...
So anyway, back to talking about Avengers. Let's not waste our breath talking about it. It's so bad. It's this. I mean, it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of action. You know, you expect. Mm-hmm. I think Joss Whedon really nailed the banter of the Avengers between each other.
Yeah, language.
Yeah, the dialogue is really good.
Language. No, don't worry, that's not a spoiler. That's only the first 10 minutes. Anyway, yeah, so, I feel like that was well done. Oh, it's a squig!
Oh, it's two dead IG is what it is. Or, excuse me, Astromilitarum.
No, there's still Imperial Guard in this game.
You know the problem with them, like, changing the names of the armies, like, Space Marine will be now, was it,
Astartes.
Yeah, Adeptus Astartes? You can't scream, Adeptus Astartes! It just doesn't scream as well.
Oh, I took that in the face.
I shot him! I was shooting him. Wasn't I?
Well, he blew up on you.
I had the trigger. Anyway.
Low ammo.
Yeah, you're low ammo.
Yeah, you wish. I never run out of ammo with a knife.
Yeah, good luck killing a squig with a knife before it gets to you.
I'll just let it blow up on me. I'm a Space Marine! What do I care?
Oh, I have a question for you. Why do these crates, which are for the Imperial Guard, why do these have bolter ammo in them?
For their lieutenants.
Good question.
Because the lieutenants can have bolters.
Yeah, I guess.
So the ammo crate is strictly for the lieutenants.
As Niall swings at the air again! Throw grenades!
And some of the sergeants can have them too.
I don't know, try one of the bumpers. The other bumper. There you go! Hey! Figure that out.
Officers. It's for the officers' bolters. Yeah. So,
I'd like to point out that that round went straight through that orc into the explosive barrel.
Yeah, like you do. Oh, hey! Want to wait till I'm not in front of you?
Firing everywhere. Oh, look, another endless wave.
Maybe the boxes of bolter ammo is to give the Imperial Guard false hope. They're like, hey, they sent us Space Marine ammo. That means there's gonna be Space Marines here pretty soon, right, guys?
Right? Nope. Right? Now, you were late to the party. At this point, they've been on this planet for, like, what, 3 months?
Yeah, well, it could have been like, 5 days, but, I mean, there's a big window. It's kind of like when you call cable to come fix it, and you call the cable company. Yeah, well, Space Marine is the same sort of thing, where you have, like, a window. It's, like, 5 days or up to 37 days. Like, that's what it showed, right?
And sometimes it's one, sometimes it's the other. Sometimes they call you going, sorry, we couldn't come to your house today.
Right.
Yeah, so... Oh, God! Stop!
Just throw grenades.
I don't know.
I'm out of grenades.
Oh, that sucks for you.
There is more grenades.
Yeah, hey, there's some ammo. No, that's for the bolt gun.
You don't need grenades, you don't need bolt guns, you have a chainsaw now.
Groovy. That's true.
Groovy. Alright, so...
Oh shit, that's a big motherfucker.
I think the best part for me, as I mentioned, is like, besides James Spader, but like, the best part that was, the best scene, was the, for me, was the mid-credits scene.
With Thanos?
Yeah, I mean, oh god, spoilers, whatever. I mean, yeah, it's more.
There's no end credit scene, by the way.
Yeah, nothing, there is no after
credits. There's nothing after credits. Oh god,
Niall's gonna die.
Maybe they decided to move it up to end credits because maybe people were upset that they're having to wait so long for that.
I don't think that's a lot to ask.
Oh god.
No, I mean, I wait to the end of the credits on every movie anyway.
XXXY.
Yeah, dude.
Hug.
He's already dead. Too late.
Yeah,
everyone else finished it for you.
I mean, that's the idea, right?
Yeah, you're supposed to look good.
That's what happens when you
X's right? Kiss, by the way, O's hug.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, no one ever.
No one's ever written you a love note?
We'll tell you when you're older. It's okay.
Yeah, but I'm excited for Infinity War.
Oh yeah, totally.
Yeah. Guardians was good. I think it's only up from there.
I keep wanting to like mention some things about, but I don't want to spoil it, like the movie.
Yeah. All I've got to say is the story. Like, I was like enjoying the movie, but the whole time I'm just like, this storyline is so crazy. Like, how everything like lines up.
The way Guardians 2 is looking is weird. It's like suddenly Star Lord's like dealing with dinosaurs and stuff or something.
What?
I've not seen that.
Oh, yeah, okay.
What?
A female Imperial Guard? What?
Well, that whole scene.
What, that happens? I got like 3 female IG figures?
I have an entire IG army, and I don't have a single female figure in it.
Oh.
It's not because, like, I specifically avoided them.
And Grey Knights.
You
don't
need
come
to buy special characters. If you want female figures, you gotta buy special characters.
Grey Knights don't come in girl form.
Oh yeah, they do. It's called Sisters of Battle.
Not quite the same, but yeah.
Remember when the Sisters of Battle were cool, aren't they?
Remember when they were? Not?
Yeah. Oh, you guys.
No one's like, fuck you, I spent so much money.
No, it's not for nothing. You can play them.
I can play them.
Yeah.
I gotta, you know, use my phone for a codex, but I can play them.
You at all bitter, Nolan?
A little bit. So, she wouldn't have that scar on her eyebrow if she could wear a helmet.
No one wears a helmet in the 41st millennium.
Well, no, plenty of people do, but once you're in charge, they take it away.
They
give it to some grunt.
Pick up Purity Seal. Those are...
Oh, so you're not going to be banging her.
Ah, see what you did there?
It's like a chastity belt. I love how far that door like went into that wall. Like it had already been opening for like 2 seconds before you even saw the edge of the door.
These are big doors, Nolan. They got Space Marines.
Well, I'm not talking about the size of the frame. I'm talking about like the
secure.
Door moved
they're
for like.
Saving content. Please don't turn off system.
All right, we'll try.
Get to the front line. I thought everything was the front line at this point.
Oh man!
I mean,
like the symbols, like this fist, like slam Lincoln. Get to the front line.
Yeah.
Heavy artillery.
A bunker?
Alright, I'm in charge of this operation, so I'll come in here.
You know what? I think they should do with that bunker is they should make those firing slits a lot narrower.
Yeah.
Because you could fit a whole orc through that
hole. But Space Marines.
Keep catching up.
Space Marines don't go inside bunkers, Jake. This
is also true.
I just went in one, Nolan.
Well, no,
yeah, but you felt really uncomfortable. You felt really uncomfortable the whole time. I was really hoping Bebop and Rocksteady were gonna come out of that.
That's a Ninja Turtles movie. Dude, did you hear what Bebop and Rocksteady did to the Donatello?
What?
In the comics.
No, I don't read Ninja Turtle comics.
Oh, who was it? Which?
It had to be Ryan that told you, I'm sure.
No. I'm trying to remember which of the Ninja Turtles got their face beaten in by Bebop and Rocksteady sledgehammers.
Oh, no way. Is it back to being like really like violent?
And they killed one of the Ninja Turtles, Bebop and Rocksteady.
What?
Yeah, and not. I mean, when I say kill, they like beat them to death with hammers, man.
Oh man,
that's pretty dark.
I didn't think that could happen.
Because like who's like right? Ninja Turtles was lighthearted.
Well, okay, the original Ninja Turtle comics was
dark.
The first run of Ninja Turtle comics, I would believe that would happen in. I wouldn't have been like, what? No way, because I'd be like, that's exactly what happens in that comic. But then when they started like making it into like this kid's show, it was like cartoon back in the 80s, and like they some
Nile
other
walking into
they started
wall.
Like making the comics. Someone else started making the comics. They really
Nile getting shot in the back.
Toned everything down, and they made it. They made it for kids. I mean, someone like Ryan could explain this a lot better than I could, I think, but
yeah,
it definitely was not for kids at first.
Okay. I didn't actually know that.
Yeah, it.
Funebra.
I want to say like Frank Miller was involved, but I don't quote me on that because I could be completely wrong.
Who's Frank Miller? I don't know.
Yeah.
What has he done?
That was totally me. I did that.
Obviously. Look at that artillery piece. That thing is on fire.
Yep.
Wow, look at that. Look at that fiber graphics. So I'm glad I didn't spend money on this game.
Yeah, I picked it up for like $5.
It was gifted.
This is a gift, right?
Yeah, it was given to me by my boss.
Oh, he didn't even spend money on it, right?
No, that dude became
or
red.
It's glowing. It's glowing.
And he didn't even spend money on it, right? It was like given to him.
So GW gave a bunch of licenses to game stores to promote this when it came out, as well as posters and stuff. Which is funny to me, like they wanted us to promote something because we're not at all popular, but whatever. So we got free licenses in the game, I guess.
I guess maybe the idea might have been though that like someone who hasn't played 40k would pick up the game and like it and then see the poster and be like, oh boy, I liked that game, and they go into the store and they actually buy the real game. That might have been the concept.
Well, maybe.
Yeah.
Well, the miniatures game is better than this. Let's be fair.
Yeah. Did you ever play? Remember they have those special rules?
You can tear it off now.
What?
Press X.
Yeah, oh, dude, carrying yourself a heavy bolter.
Now I'm a devastator.
For the Emperor.
You can't sprint? Oh, good.
Well, it wouldn't make any sense, you know?
I'm just saying, in the game, if you move with the thing, you can't even shoot. But,
he slows down when you go to pull the trigger. A little bit. One Gretchen is just chilling out with the commander. And all your Space Marines are just watching it
happen.
Why is
it three Space Marines and the person is in charge of all the remaining Imperial Guard on this planet doing this?
Yeah, she can't send an aide. She doesn't, like, say, like, hey, you, Johnson, go with these guys. Why does she have to, like, personally... But that's how you get ahead in the militaries of the, you know, the grimdark future where there is only war.
Yeah, I guess so. You just gotta lead from the front.
That's how it goes.
Take your lickings and I guess.
Yeah, you gotta have your grimdark. That's just how it's done in Grimdark.
What do we got? Ooh, Stalker! So this is your sniper rifle. Oh, yeah. It's not that powerful of a sniper rifle.
This game's bad. Damn, look at that gun.
That is where you're going.
And it's like, you go in there and like, standby, iron control. And you like, shoot Star Destroyers from
there. Fire giant poop nipple gun.
We haven't been able to make it inside.
There just aren't enough of us.
Although this one has really long nipple. This long on your That's own, weird.
Yeah, it's a... You have done well.
Don't praise her! Make her send her... her...
You are no longer alone! We will retake the gun with
you. Know,
is that the point of the Imperial Guard is to be expendable?
Look.
Yeah.
If I learned one,
that dude back there is a badass in that mask. I want
Yeah, send that guy.
That guy looks like he's ready to kill someone.
If I learned anything as a Boy Scout, that leadership, a big part of leadership is delegation. And if she were a real leader, she would have delegated someone to go on this mission.
Yeah, she wouldn't have.
If she is the ranking, if she is the ranking officer, and being a second lieutenant, because that says second lieutenant, right? She is the only officer.
Yeah,
you got it. Need a low on the chain.
At best, there's other second lieutenants.
Right.
Bam.
They just haven't been lieutenants as long as her.
Yeah, but I mean, come on.
Ooh, look at that.
That's a burnt wall.
That was like a.
I did that. That was me.
No, that was probably a lab
that
game.
Was me. No, that was you landing.
That was me.
Splat.
Oh, don't you get a last cannon at some point in this game?
Yep. Yeah, it replaces that gun, but that's like way later in the game.
Oh.
Yeah, you're not gonna see it. You're gonna love the plasma gun though. Look at Niall miss all those shots. And I love how he keeps meleeing the air.
That's because the reload button in Halo is the melee button in this game.
Yeah, they should have just like if you're gonna imitate something like they did, you might as well just imitate Halo. Much better game.
Yep. I think anymore, I would just like if I were to make a shooter, for instance, I would like just have the same exact control scheme as like Call of Duty.
Yeah, Call of Duty.
I wouldn't bother like with any other control scheme. Like let's just make it Call of Duty, and all those COD players will just
No problem.
Mm-hmm. Give him anything to bitch about.
Niall, you started a venture in COD Blops.
Alright, so Steam had a sale, a big sale this weekend. In addition to picking up like every Star Wars game we're playing for like $20,
Dark Forces.
Yeah. Dark Forces were playing.
Dark Forces was the shit.
Yeah, I know.
But anyway,
I was the only one that played
it.
I played it.
No one played this shit.
You didn't play it. That's right.
Yeah, I played that game like when it like first came out, which is
though,
years before it was on the PlayStation.
I tell you this though, I played a shitload of Jedi Knight.
Oh yeah,
and I did not.
Dark Forces 2.
No one played. Man, I played so much multiplayer Jedi Knight.
I remember that.
It was ridiculous.
Like, you and best friend at the time.
Yeah.
I remember mom and dad got a second phone line. Just so you could be on the phone with him.
Okay, so this is way back in the day of dial-up, by the way.
Yeah,
God, do you remember those days?
I try to forget those kind of days. Mom and I got a second phone line for the internet specifically, and I remember you tying up the regular phone line while you were playing.
This is also before headsets.
Yep.
So if you wanted to coordinate...
Not like internet at the time could have handled multiplayer and voice.
Right, and so... that's how it had to be done, is you needed two lines, one to dial up and play your multiplayer interwebs game, and you needed another phone line if you wanted to coordinate,
tactics
and stuff.
Yeah.
So,
in addition to picking up, all the Star Alliance, we picked up, Call of Duty, Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, and Ghosts. That's the other one.
Blops.
I have a policy where I won't pay more than $30 for Call of Duty because I don't like the multiplayer in Call of Duty. And while fun, the single player campaigns are not worth $60.
No, nope, it's more like a DLC.
So they're not worth the $100.
Oh yeah, it's $60 for COD Blops 3 and $40 for the season pass.
Or 50 or something. $40 or $50 for the season
not
pass.
Worth it.
Yeah, no, not worth it.
Well, I mean, most of those DLC in the season pass are gonna be multiplayer.
Or Battlefront, yeah, when maybe, that comes out.
Yeah.
So anyway, I picked up. I beat Blops yesterday, and I played through some of Blops 2 this morning. COD Blops 2.
Yeah.
I don't
that
know, man.
That kind of sums it up.
I don't know, man. Like, I can't... The inner history buff me can't call Black Ops a good game.
No.
Like, here's the thing. So, Treyarch made World of War, which was one of the best shooter games I've ever played.
And, I mean, I know a lot of people had problems with it because the multiplayer, I guess, wasn't great. But the single-player campaign was fantastic. It was the best Russian campaign I've ever seen in a shooter game. And so,
even better than Red Orchestra?
I haven't played Red Orchestra.
Is a different crowd.
Yeah,
very different crowd.
So I was kind of making a joke there in that, like...
Well, Red Orchestra, think about Red Orchestra, is it's more or less a physics demonstration, like, really. I mean, it comes down to it. When you look at it, like, I feel like when I played that game, I was like, this feels like it's just here to demonstrate someone's ability to program physics.
Yeah. Look at all this horde. Look at that horde. Fire bra. All that blood. This is like 300 violence.
Well, I mean... Yeah.
It goes into, like, slow-mo, too.
I'm assuming it doesn't do that in any combo and multiplayer.
No.
So anyway...
You can kill him.
You bisect him from asshole to chin. Look at that.
So anyway...
Hold him, bro!
Hold him, bro! Hey, look at that. That's a gun shooting thing. I like this.
It's like a walk at head.
Something to shoot at up there. Oh, look at there's an orc just sitting there.
Big old walk.
You're right. Oh, look at that. Your two space marines are just watching that whole thing go on.
They're like,
that's another thing.
They're sitting there like,
they're terrible.
Well, they're sitting there like, how long do you think before this orc does anything?
Yeah. So anyway, I
love the aesthetics of 40. It's just like, let's put skulls everywhere. Oh, what's this? This switch to open the door is just it's not doing it for me. You know,
big enough.
Put a skull on it.
Yeah.
So
this button, let's just make it a skull-shaped button.
Yeah, skulls for days.
I'm guessing all shifter knobs are skulls too, by the way.
Oh yeah, that goes without saying.
Oh, that reminds me of something. I want to come back to skull shifter knobs. Don't forget that. So back to Cod Bops. So I played through Cod Bops. I like the setting, like the like height of the height of the Cold War.
A little further back.
Height of the Cold War setting, you know, like doing shit in like Cambodia and Laos and stuff.
And Afghanistan.
I love that setting. Like that's one thing I loved about.
Jetpack.
Whoa! Hello.
Hit it again. Or not.
Metal Gear Solid 3.
Metal Gear Solid 3 is where I was getting with that. I was distracted. Sorry. It's so
tantalizing colors.
Oh yeah, I remember this part. You have to like run across the rooftops and shoot the guys that your rescue squad misses.
When you jetpack up, you can slam down on them.
So anyway, so I really like the setting. And you know, I can forgive like some like crazy technology usage because it's like a lot of the stuff they do was like in development at the time, and you have the argument, you know, you're a CIA guy, and so they give you the best stuff or whatever, right? And
I'm waiting until Niall figures out that glowing space marine icon means that he goes Super Saiyan.
Yeah, I don't know. So anyway,
Niall hasn't figured out the jetpack either.
Jetpacks go up.
Yeah. Hold A.
It's a jump pack.
There you go. Hold A.
Hey!
Let's slam down for full damn bro.
So anyway,
for some cool shit.
So
you stun him,
and then you execute him. Get health back. I don't care. Execute him anyway. I want to see someone get like combo animation.
Yeah,
like,
that's worth the price of admission.
So. Yeah, so anyway, I was saying, I can forgive some like anachronistic technology usage. You can
like
argue,
ACOGs.
Like, yeah, you can argue, like, right now was in development in the late 60s, early 70s, or whatever, and the CIA, you know, have access to the best technology for their operators. And, but I picked up at one point, Rust!
Stomp your widow head!
Oh, that was violent. So I picked up at one point an AK-47 from the VC that had a red funnel on it.
That seems, impossible.
Yeah, pretty much impossible.
Yeah, it was, yeah, and I was like, okay, well. Oh, and then the cheesy ending of that game, man. Have you beaten it?
Nah.
So, like, you end up blowing up this, like, hidden Russian installation under the ocean that's sending out signals to sleeper cells, or sleeper agents, right?
Okay.
And you end up blowing it up, and you surface, and there's, like, the entire U.S. Navy. There's, like, destroyers and destroyers, and, like, what's going on?
You're dying. I don't know.
So anyway, there's
open the door.
Yeah, let's kill the door. So there's like destroyers and stuff, and like a bunch of like marines and marine craft and shit, and like jets are flying over. There's American flags on everything, and it was like, holy shit.
America.
Yeah, I was like, America, work here. So anyway.
I don't think our Navy did that in the 60s and 70s.
I feel it like did if it was a movie happen. Made in the 80s. I mean.
Ah, yeah, that's true.
What?
Red Dawn or something. I don't know.
So
wait, that was a different movie.
Yeah, so, and I'm playing through Couple Ops 2 presently, and it's like, I'm like, okay, so it's in the future. We got some of these crazy technology, but I'm looking at the stuff like, this game takes place in 2025. There's no fucking way we're gonna get. Oh, I just said a bad word.
I said a bad word.
We're not. There's no way we're gonna reach that level of technology in 10 years. No way.
It's got Michael Rooker in it.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, I walked in the room.
I showed it to Nolan. I was like, yeah. So this is Couple Ops 2. Nolan's like, oh, hey, it's Michael Rooker. And
I noticed him by his voice.
Exactly. I mean, I couldn't notice by his face.
Hey, it's that guy for Guardians of the Galaxy.
Because I'm not good with names. I'm good with faces and voices.
I only remember his name because he was on the radio the other day because he was here at the Comic-Con in Vegas.
Mm. Well, he was the villain in, what was that? Slither.
Lots of stuff.
Slither.
Yeah.
Oh.
same director as Guardians of the Galaxy, by the way.
Yeah. That's the only reason I watched that?
Nathan Fillion?
Mm-hmm.
Who was also in Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yep.
As some, like, alien...
I've yet to actually see him still.
Disappointed. He's credited, though.
Yeah, it's really disappointing I haven't seen him yet. I mean, it's cool. I'm a really big fan of his.
Yeah, we know you have an impression. That's fine.
It's okay. No impression.
Like, Castle is my favorite TV show that I don't get to watch.
I haven't watched Castle in a few years.
Yeah, he got married and, like...
See,
no,
I...
Okay, if my Facebook feed is anything to go off, no, he hasn't.
I thought he did. I don't know.
They were supposed to get married. Boom. Like, shit keeps happening. It's like 3 seasons later or something. I don't really know.
Yeah. See, I stopped watching before they, like, hooked up. But he had told her he loved her.
Yeah, that happened.
And the thing that I kind of didn't like is, like, one of the huge dynamics of the show is their back and forth.
Yeah, that was the best dynamic before they ever got together. It was just the tension.
Yeah, and you lose all that when they get together. And it's like the
then it became
they
just
did the same
running
same thing happened. The same thing happened in like X-Files, I think.
Yeah. They're making a new X-Files. Oh no, okay, so Skull Shifter now. I just remember.
Oh yeah, Skull Shifter now.
Holy
what comes
shit.
Out next week?
Holy shit, does Mad Max look cool. I am so excited for Mad Max. I've been way more excited for Mad Max than I have been for Avengers 2. You have no idea.
Yeah, but you're a big fan of the original.
I wasn't a big fan of the original Mad Max. I was a huge fan of Road Warrior.
Road Warrior.
Yeah, Mad
That's
Max
right.
2.
Road Mad, Max,
Mad Max 2.
Mad Max is honestly kind of boring.
Yeah, the original Mad Max is kind of boring. Road Warrior is awesome. The first like half
Action
of Thunder
roll.
First
Action
first half of Thunderdome is good. The
until
last
he leaves
half.
Thunderdome.
Until he leaves Bartertown.
Bartertown, yeah. Until he leaves Bartertown, it's good.
Yeah, up until the Thunderdome part. Which is like halfway through the movie, and then it gets weird and like there's like these kids and they think he's like their long lost god or something. Captain Waka.
Waka.
Well, they're Australian. Captain Waka.
Are they in Australia?
Yeah, they're in Australia.
Not to be confused with Walker from Mountain.
Yeah, it's Captain Walker is the name.
Waka.
But
he's a Waka.
They're all low class Australians and they say Waka. Captain Walker.
Against low class Australians?
No, nothing against low class Australians, but they say they don't pronounce ours.
I'm jealous of their money. Their cash. I'm not gonna lie. Their cash is cool. Have you seen it?
Plastic money.
Plastic.
Yeah. That'd be kind of interesting to switch to that.
But,
more guns!
Yeah, so.
More
engine launchers. South Park parodied it.
Okay. Well, time out.
So this is a grenade launcher?
Time out. I've been playing Warhammer for a long time. What the hell is this?
Yeah, I know. When you first get it, you're like, oh, cool, grenade launcher that I've never seen. No, it's not even a grenade launcher, really.
What does it do?
It's a depth charge launcher.
When does it blow up?
You pull right trigger, or left trigger, sorry.
Nope, that's the name.
Try another button, I don't know.
Nope, that's melee still.
Because, I don't remember. I didn't play it with the controller, remember? Yeah. I played with the keyboard.
Nope.
Try clicking one of the... now you just activated your superpower, your Super Saiyan.
Yeah, as you're about to run out before it has any use.
That's okay. The more gore you create on screen, the faster that charges up.
Yeah, so whatever.
We still haven't figured out how to blow it up.
Alright, so that launches it.
Yeah, so those two icons, those are telling you how many you have active.
Oh,
what'd you do?
It's right trigger, or right bumper.
Ah, yeah.
Okay, it's kind of a lame weapon.
Yeah, it gets really good when you just like, I want a line here so that when they inevitably overwhelm me.
I suppose.
Shit, dude, I'm a space marine. Sorry, I'm a space marine!
Yes, pronounce it right, Niall.
Space marine!
It's heretical.
Space marine any other way!
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be a heretic.
No, because you get killed by a space marine!
Suffer not the witch to live.
No, you should be killed by Sisters of Battle. And they're supposed to be the militant arm of the ecclesiarchy.
Yeah, not anymore. Matt Ward, fuck that shit.
Fuck you, Matt Ward.
I sense you don't like Matt Ward.
Yeah, nobody who actually can call themselves like a Warhammer player can like Matt Ward.
Okay, so I don't like Matt Ward then.
No, you don't like Matt Ward.
You're the lucky 4chan. Matt Ward.
Negative Ghost Rider.
Oh my god. Oh,
Jesus, dude.
The hatred that just spews out at that guy.
I'm okay with that. That kind of thing happens all the time on the internet.
Okay. It's funny, though.
That looks like a Meltamine.
That's a Meltabomb.
Or a Meltabomb.
Oh, yeah. Put those in the right place.
I feel like he wants you to pick it up, but you can't reach because you can't climb, because you can't touch your chin,
you can't jump,
because you can't turn right. Oh, you were waiting for him to talk about it.
The prompt.
So I do like all this Adeptus Mechanicus stuff, like the building and the architecture and whatnot. Feels very much in line with what we associate 40K to be.
So, have you seen the new Adeptus Mechanicus
infantry? They're impressive.
Yeah, they're really cool. I bought a box like the basic infantry, but I haven't built them yet.
Yeah, they're super cool.
I almost thinking I want to wait till I can take a look at the codex so I can figure out like what options I really want to put on them. Because they have like two different guns and
squad weapons. And...
Well, if you go on their website and you look at like how they're they sell them to you, it's almost as if that one box is actually two different troop choice options, and I don't know which one I would want. I'm not entirely sure, because usually they'll put two, I mean, if the one box contains two troop choices, it'll tell you that on the box.
Kind of like the revamped war.
You know what's interesting, though, and this is new to me, is in that box there was a stat line entry for... Yeah. Did I shoot that orc through my own dude?
Yep.
Yeah.
There's no friendly fire.
That would be heretical to have friendly fire.
Yes, it would.
Well, friendly fire has the right of way.
So anyway, they put a stat line in the
in the instruction manual.
It has the entry from the codex. It tells you like what the stats are, what they can be equipped.
That's
like,
interesting because they've never done that.
Well, it's cool because it's like they finally realize
there's
like
blood on that wall.
If I don't know what I'm doing with this army, I can look at that and go, I want that weapon and that weapon. And I know how many special weapons I'm going to have in the squad. Like, without the codex, how would you know that you'd have a third special weapon if you have a squad of 10 in that game?
No idea.
Right. You'd probably have just assumed it was two, like every other Imperial army.
Of course, they probably are under the impression that if you're buying those guys, you have the codex.
So,
but
yeah, but
I don't.
It's cool because, like, that way you can go, ah!
Ah!
So that way you can go, ah!
Yes.
Look at that. Look at them shoot. Well, you know, Space Marines shoot sniper rifles from the hip all the time.
Yeah, how else would you
by the way, if you've never played 40K before, Space Marines have no option. Regular Space Marines have no option for getting a sniper rifle. Only ever Scout Troops. I find that kind of funny.
Well, this isn't a full-on sniper rifle. It's like a long special. Back to that thing. I think it's cool they finally realized like, we can put this in here for people who don't really know what they want to do with the army yet, or know what they're doing with the army yet.
Right.
Because it don't give you what any of the weapons do, so you still need the codex. you know, it's not like they're removing your the necessity of the codex by putting it in
there. Right. Mm-hmm.
But it lets you know how you want to build your army if you don't happen to have the book there with you.
Yeah.
And that's cool. I like the direction Grimdark is going in. You can't say the same fantasy at the moment. We'll see how that
goes. Do you ever see play with those rules? They had like a rules option for like, they called it like movie marines or something like that.
Oh, and they had
like these basically like,
I still have that.
Yeah,
that,
one white door. It was like one squad of guys.
Is an army.
Yeah, it's a whole army.
It's
they would like
1500
point
army.
Up.
It's a 10-man squad.
Yeah, and each dude is like a hero or a lord or.
Yeah, their like stats are like really huge, and then I think they get like, I think they have invulnerable saves. And...
Yeah, they have multiple wounds, single dude, and they have like each of their guns shoots.
Yeah,
like,
the point is so that one squad of guys would be able to take an entire Warhammer army.
Yeah,
just like what you are in this game.
Yeah, basically it was like this.
Is that chick still with you, or is she?
Nah, you left her behind a long time ago. You remember that?
No.
Cutscene?
Was a
cutscene? Yeah. No. Like,
I think we were talking about Avengers.
Yeah, we were talking about that, and then we were talking about delegation.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. How she's a bad leader.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She delegated to you to now take it. Or you delegated yourself to do it.
I think I'm like a captain or something. Yeah, nobody should. You're not
used to not having that see-through things
from
COD Blops 2. Yeah, I watched Niall play that for a while, and I was like, wait, you have a gun that can just shoot through cover? Then why are these guys even fighting me?
Well, it's not that the gun, I mean, the gun can shoot through cover, it's a regular 5.56 gun. It's that it can see through cover.
Yeah.
Like, it's got x-ray scope on it.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Or something.
But, anyway, I mean, maybe we've been doing this long enough. I've had it with this game. It's so bad.
You've been doing the same thing for 40 minutes, dude.
I've been doing the same thing for a while in this game. What the... Okay. I'm out. I'm out. I'm done.
It's a factory.
I'm turning over here. I'm walking this way. This was fun, though. I enjoyed our conversation. Can't say the same about the game.
Yeah, I miss you, Ryan. Come back.
Come back, Ryan. When you're not here, Ryan, they make me play bad video games.
I'm sure we could find worse games for you to play.
Yeah. Maybe next time we'll play.
You know what? I'm looking up at yourself right there. You know what I see in yourself right there? Enter the Matrix.
You know what? Okay, I paid $3 for that game. About a month after it came out. Paid $3 for it. At Big Lots, of all places. It's the same place we got Homeworld.
Homeworld was well worth the price, though. Homeworld's a good game.
It was. Into the Matrix, it was fun. I like how you put in cheat codes in that game because you type in codes before you before you jack into the Matrix and it affects you in the Matrix. Let's see. What's some other stuff we can up there that...
We can play Expendabros.
We could. Oh, yeah.
Or Pro Force. Front Mission Evolved.
Front Mission Evolved. Yeah, it's such a
Far Cry. Can you try Blood Dragon?
Blood Dragon's a good game, though.
The problem with Blood Dragon is it makes fun of itself more than we could make fun of it.
Yeah, like, I played the first 5 minutes of it, and I died of laughing. Like, my character died because I was laughing.
That is, like, so
80s. Yeah. We'll figure something out next time Ryan can't make it. Or maybe even if he can make it, we'll save.
Oh, what's that Lego game you got there?
Oh,
Lego Alpha Team. Wasn't that like a puzzle game?
That game was a lot of fun. I'm gonna be perfectly honest with you. That game's a lot of fun. But I'm a big fan of puzzle games. So hopefully you enjoyed this.
And subscribe.
Like down there. Down at the bottom. Down at the bottom of the screen, down there.
Where Niall's shooting the ground.
Down there. Hit the subscribe button, like this movie. This video.
Yeah, we make movies now.
We make movies now. We're movie makers. Like this video, subscribe.
Cinematographers.
You know, the next time they make you play a bad game.
I didn't make you play it.
Yeah.
Niall
selected this game.
I did not select this game. Owen was like, let's play a bad game. And I was like, I don't have a few of those. And he goes, this is basically bad.
Well, admittedly, Ryan would have probably been like, let's play LOL.
Look at me dance.
All we need is the club music.
Yeah. Alright. Bye.
Yeah.
Bye, guys.